Welcome, welcome, everybody. This is Cool Cat Terry from The Platform, bringing to you the very much and highly anticipated Triggered compilation video for the Uncharted series. Now, for those of you who have played or are currently fans of Naughty Dog's creation of Uncharted, you probably already know what's coming, all right? Yes, you may be fans of the series, but you can still hopefully accept the fact that, you know, Uncharted isn't Uncharted without copying itself. Now, we're going to go ahead and we're going to dive into some different gameplay footage and things like that that are going to show exactly what I'm talking about. So prepare yourselves, all right? This is a Triggered video showing everything that got copied. Things, you know, from The Lost Legacy, Uncharted 2, 3, and 4. So be prepared. Be prepared, you guys. Now, this all started when just a little prior to the release of Uncharted's The Lost Legacy, the co-writer, Josh Scheer, had a lovely little interview with Metro UK. He was asked if there had been anything similar, because they noticed that there was a scene in The Lost Legacy that reminded them of a Madagascar level. So Josh Scheer then replied, "Everything is brand new from scratch." So that's where we are today. This is why I'm triggered, because the co-writer had said that everything was from scratch in The Lost Legacy. Well, that is not the case, okay? I'm going to show you all the different things that have been rehashed, reused, copy-pasted, you know, between The Lost Legacy and previous games within the Uncharted worlds, proving The Lost Legacy is not from scratch, you guys. Here we go. All right, you guys, here we have Chloe taking a nice slow stroll through the marketplace. Nice and slow walk, being forced to do this, gets kind of tedious. But then, look at this, Uncharted 4, Nathan Drake, what we got? Another forced slow walk where we have Bob and Weave through a crowded fucking market. Come on! Uncharted 3! What is this? A young Nathan Drake! Once again, a forced slow walk through a goddamn market. Uncharted 3,
cut through the market.
Now we're older Nathan Drake. Guess what? Once again, we're forced to do a slow goddamn walk through a frickin' marketplace. Now we have Chloe, you know, looking over an Indian city. What happens? The frickin' Indian military just bombs their own civilians! What the fuck? This is so metal! Holy shit!
Well, that may be easier said than done.
Now we start to see a theme. Alright, back in Uncharted 2, what happens?
Bingo.
Innocent civilians get bombed by tyrants! Alright, why do we gotta keep seeing this happen? I mean, yeah, we have bad guys and they're gonna, you know, destroy shit, but why are they destroying their own goddamn people all the damn time?
Now what?
Patience.
Now, does anybody have a sign here? Is there a sign? I can really use a sign. Oh yeah, here, don't worry. Naughty Dog has provided plenty of frickin', you know, store signage that clearly cannot hold, you know, a person's body weight so we can traverse through a frickin' city. Cause you know, this makes goddamn sense. But you know, no worries. There's plenty of these perfectly placed signs that are perfectly capable of holding, you know, Chloe's weight. Some bullshit. Now I'm pretty sure we did this before, did we not? Pretty sure we did this before. Oh yeah, Uncharted 2, guess what? Nathan Drake climbing around on signage. And I'm like, what? This stuff cannot hold people's weight, okay? This can't. All this shit would have broke. All of it. I mean, yeah, they show some of them falling down a little bit here and there, but you know what? None of them would have held a person's body weight. None of them. You know what? This is definitely not from scratch. Since how he did it in Uncharted fucking 2.
Clear the streets.
We'll throw ourselves out.
We don't need doors. Fuck doors. We'll just jump through goddamn windows. Run across damn rooftops. You know, we've done this a bajillion damn times in Uncharted. Look at this. Rooftops. Oh my god, is that a goddamn window? I wanna go through this fucking window. Oh shit, fucking table. Oh, no worry. I'm fine. You know, this giant fucking table didn't hurt. Is this a scene from The Lion King? In my mind, I'm thinking, you know, in the jungle, the mighty jungle.
Nathan?
No worries. More boat scenes.
Land ho.
So many boat scenes. I mean, I really could have just made a whole goddamn, you know, triggered video just on boat scenes alone. Alright? We're always on a goddamn boat. But no worries, I only picked this one because, you know, I didn't want to, you know, bore you guys with all the goddamn boat scenes. What a beautiful jungle paradise! It's so beautiful! I mean, Naughty Dog did do a fantastic job, you know, with their graphic ability when it comes to the nature stuff. Bravo. But, you mean, I would expect them to do a beautiful job with a jungle scene, because they do the fucking jungle scenes in every goddamn game as well. Hell, I can go on the goddamn Vita and even do another jungle scene. But you know what? Fuck the goddamn Vita. I'm just gonna showcase, you know, Uncharted damn 4, where once again, you know, we're gonna have a beautiful fucking topside view of a jungle goddamn landscape. Come on, Naughty Dog. Jungles are nice, jungles are cool, but come on. Can we not go someplace else? Why is everything hidden in the jungle?
So what made you change your mind?
Huh? Everything's in a goddamn jungle!
Must have come back.
Let's enjoy the scenery, shall we? The good old open world car scenes, you guys. We've done this a lot. Now here we are with Chloe, we got Nadine, we're going for a nice little leisure drive in the jungle. We got our Jeep that can clearly, you know, traverse and every kind of terrain. Deep water, no problem, don't worry. I can even go up a goddamn waterfall in this Jeep! One of a kind, everybody. This hasn't been done. Right, it's all from scratch.
Hey,
wait.
So with our luck, what are the
what's this?
Volcano's gonna erupt on
we're in a goddamn zero. Jeep again.
It's extinct.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. All right, no worries. You know, just drive around this Jeep. And, you know,
wait, Sully, you're
it's perfectly fine. We haven't done this before.
Research?
I bet you this Jeep can also, you know, go through every damn thing. Oh my god. We're gonna bush it. We're gonna go through mud. You know. Climb over giant fucking rocks and things. You know, what is this? Huh. Oh my goodness. Puzzles with shadows? Puzzles with shadows. I mean, come on.
If I had a guess,
come on, you guys.
Some kind of lock mechanism to open that door.
Slide shit around. Get all these lovely little shadows to line up perfectly with the pictures in the background. I mean, it's a cool little puzzle and all. But, as I was playing this, this seemed very familiar to something else that I did. Very familiar. So, you know, but anyways, once you got all this stupid shit slid around, and all your little shadows lined up just fine, then you would be able to open up, you know, the little fucking door in the back so you can, you know, continue on with the freaking story. Well done, Chloe, well done. Anyways, Uncharted 3. Here we
Sully,
have Nathan fucking
lighter.
Around with right. goddamn right. shit. Yeah, give me a damn lighter. I have shadows I need to create, damn it. Anyways, to keep this one short and sweet, I didn't do all the running around. But anyways, if you ran around a bunch, there's all these fucking limbs and things you can move shadows with to try to see which one's lined up just right. But to keep things, you know, short and sweet, like I said, go right to the correct one. Boom, the shadows, they line up perfectly with the picture in back. Bam! Guess what that does? It opens up a fucking door in the back. Fantastic. Fantastic, Naughty Dog. You know, reusing things that you've already done. I mean, yeah, you gave it a little tweak. It's a little bit different, but still the same concept.
Oh, shit. Get down, get down.
Oh, my goodness. Another, I've got all these damn APCs.
Holy shit.
Naughty Dog loves the APCs.
Oh, he stepped in it now.
I don't know how that thing didn't run freaking Chloe over.
Not getting that.
She should have been, you know, smushed in that there grass.
This will put a dent in that APC. Lost
yep,
now.
Rocket launcher. That, you know... There you go. Get all explosives. Get all explosives! Blow those shit up! Oh my god, we got another APC! Who would have thought we would have more APCs in an Uncharted game? Don't worry, Nathan's got this. Nathan has got this, you guys. Let's do a little rolling around. We're gonna shoot some bad guys, you know. Try to ignore the stupid APC that's hunting us down. No worries. No worries!
Another one?
Damn right, a fucking another one. Naughty Dog has a freaking hard-on for APCs. There's so many APCs. This is another situation where I could have, you know, made a whole video just on appearances of APCs. But I decided to just limit it down to these three. You better run, boy! Run! Because, you know, there's no way none of these bullets would have killed you. Instantly. Alright, we got, you know, RPG perfectly placed. Yep, he's dead. You know, clearly he got hit by those bullets. I saw the red, and whatever.
What happened with him?
Bullshit.
He was the guy that couldn't walk away.
Anyways, for those of you who don't understand why I'm doing this, this is the main protagonist, Chloe, going over her story about her father and his obsession, trying to find, you know, treasures about some cultural thing.
Bandits raided his camp.
Whoop-de-doo-da. I mean, we've been there and done that, haven't we? Where the main protagonist has a parental figure who's obsessed and trying to find something. I'm pretty sure this has been done.
I'm sorry. Oh, hey. He certainly made his choice.
Such a touching moment. Let it all out, Chloe. Yeah, no worries. I couldn't clearly see what these were until I blew the dust off. Well done, Nadine. Well done. Oh, shit! It matches what my dad gave me! I guess he wasn't a crackpot. He found it. He's been here, man.
Dad was here.
He was here! He did it!
Something big, alright. Oh, why didn't that stupid bastard tell me?
Anyways, you know, big, big touching moment.
Himself. He wanted to keep you safe.
But anyways, that sums up, you know, the backstory for Chloe and her father. But now, in Uncharted 4, when we're young Nathan Drake, we also uncover his parental backstory.
What do you got there?
So they end up breaking into this lady's house. Trying to find...
That's definitely Mom's handwriting.
their mother's book.
Put up your hands. Slowly.
Hey, there's no need for that.
What is he holding?
Hey, you keep your gun on me.
Give me my journal.
All right. I'm sorry, Nathan.
Anyways, this old lady here, she is going to basically...
So what now?
Lay out the plot... that is for the mother of the Drake boys here.
I brought him down here so he could see our mom's stuff. That's it, he had nothing to do with this.
What?
I'm telling you that this is all on me.
No. Your mother's stuff. You're Cassandra Morgan's voice. We could have accomplished so much together.
But anyway, so she opens up the book and she goes on about, you know, how their mother, you know, really wanted to find out what was going on with Sir Francis Drake. All right, so this is what she was obsessed about, with Sir Francis Drake. This was the last thing that she wanted to, you know, locate and discover. But she ended up passing away, I think from cancer or something. Something happened. She ended up dying, and she wasn't able to find it. But this basically proves that Naughty Dog doesn't know how to tell a different story. So we went from Nathan, you know, finding out that his mom, you know, was obsessed with Sir Francis Drake. All right. And wasn't able to fully complete the expedition. So he ends up taking it up on his own to do so. Just like previously, we saw Chloe, you know, finding out that her father was obsessed about, you know, a cultural thing, and he wasn't able to fully complete it, and she had to take it up on her end to do it. So, two protagonists, both their parents, and the children end up finishing the expeditions both damn times. Same story, small little twist, just retold. Bullshit! But anyways, this clip here is just to show, you know, Nathan being obsessed with the whole Francis Drake tale because of what he uncovered when he was a bit younger from his mom. So this is him, you know, continuing where she left off, basically. He becomes far more obsessed about it than what Chloe did with her dad. But it's still the same story where, you know, like I said, the kid ends up having to finish where the parents left off. Alright. Nathan, like I said, he just had to do a lot more. You know, he had to do a lot of research, you know, steal shit from museums, or whatever he had to do so he could finish what his mom started. Whereas Chloe kind of just fell into it. But still, Naughty Dog was lazy as shit, you know? Let's take our main protagonist Nathan's freaking backstory that we drove into you guys. Alright, and Uncharted 3 and 4 and even, you know, the first game, whatever. We drove Francis Drake down your goddamn throats about how important this guy was to Nathan. Alright, and we're just gonna take that story, give it a little spin. A little spit and polish, you know, we'll just change the mom figure to the father figure, you know. But, you know, we'll just rehash it a little bit and throw it in the Lost Legacy and make it seem like it's a brand new fucking story. You know, some people will probably fall for it. You know, there's a lot of gullible people out there. But not me. I noticed the same fucking story being retold again. Some lazy, lazy freaking story writers working for Naughty Dog, that's for damn sure. Bullshit!
Whoa.
What on earth is this place?
Throne room.
Alright, guys. What we got here? A giant statue with lots of arms. Oh my god! When I first saw this, I was like, wait a minute. I remember seeing a large statue with multiple arms before. But wait a minute. There's gotta be something different with this one, right? It can't just be the fact that it has a... Oh, shit. Nope, it's not different. We have to move the appendages. It's not different. Yes, they made this a far larger scale, but it's the same thing. You're probably like, what the hell are you talking about, Terry? It's not the same thing. We didn't have a big fucking statue like this where we had to move the arms. We didn't do this before. What? Do they have, what, they have like some kind of weapon thing in their hand? You gotta move that too? No worry. This is all from scratch. The co-writer said so. It's all from scratch. We haven't done anything like this. This is all fucking from scratch, remember? Bullshit. I can't believe we would have to go through a very similar puzzle. Yeah, it's a far larger scale puzzle, but we've done this before. We've freaking done this before. That's, you know, manipulate some arms on a giant statue so we can do what we gotta do. Whatever, Naughty Dog, whatever. Yeah. Alright, but anyways, for those of you who have no clue what I'm talking about, let's go and dive in to, you know, Uncharted 2, where we did this before. On a smaller scale, look at that! We have a giant statue! Multiple arms, look at that, we have to maneuver these arms! What the shit? We're moving the arms? You freaking kidding me? We gotta climb around on it just like Chloe did, moving shit? Oh my goodness, look at that, oh my goodness! Yep, don't worry. We didn't do this in Lost Legacy. Yeah, we did. Thanks a lot, Naughty Dog. And once again, taking something from an older game you did, rehashing it. Well done.
Third Eye of Shiva.
Oh my goodness. So now we're gonna go ahead and start a reflecting light puzzle. Okay. So we got this beam of light, we're gonna go shimmy shine it over this way. No big deal. Giant shit coming down from the gosh darn ceiling. So what happens when you move this thing? Is this gonna be a light puzzle? I think we're gonna have a light puzzle, ladies and gentlemen.
I think it's holding.
Oh my god, we have a light puzzle! Look at these prisms! We have a light puzzle! I bet you we're gonna have to redirect that light, aren't we? Yep, it's reflected everywhere.
Okay, that did something.
Yep, so then once you get done reflecting the light and getting it to shine in the right places, you know, you can go ahead and complete that puzzle.
Hold still for just a sec.
Good job, Chloe. But then, once again, back to Uncharted 2.
Yeah, it looks like the
we have another instance. The original instance. Well, we're gonna have light coming in. And we have to reflect the beams around the room to, you know, solve a puzzle. You gotta be kidding me, Naughty Dog! I thought you said you didn't do it. The Lost Legacy was from scratch! You said this Lost Legacy was from scratch! You mean to tell me that once again you took shit from Uncharted 2, you know, which is where Chloe first made an appearance in the series, by the way, for those of you who haven't played them all. Uncharted 2 is where Chloe first showed up. So let's take a whole bunch of shit from the game where she first showed up, and we're gonna rehash it and throw it in her fucking game, The Lost Legacy, and claim that it's, you know, not from scratch, it's all brand new from the bottom up. Fuck you, Naughty Dog.
Okay, Sam, what do you got?
I have found a crate.
Oh my goodness.
Of course you did.
Sam found a goddamn crate? This is breaking news, everybody! Sam found a crate! You know, this is only his one damn job that he had in Uncharted 4. All fucking Sam did was find stupid crates for frickin' Nathan. Give him a pat on the damn back. Well done, Sam. Your whole purpose for being in any of the Uncharted games has been fulfilled because you know how to find those fucking crates.
Ready.
You got it.
Let's move this giant cart that's conveniently placed here. Drop your crate.
I jump down from up there. It's too high to get back.
Anyways, we got freaking Uncharted 4.
We can put under it.
Gotta move giant shit around. You know. But don't worry. The co-writer assured us that the, you know, moving the shit around in Lost Legacy was from scratch, you know? It was from scratch. We didn't ever have to do anything in that game before. It's all brand new stuff. But, you know, look at this. once again moving a giant freaking cart.
No thanks. We got
so we can climb up. Yep. From scratch, everybody.
Shit, motorbikes!
Oh. Let us not forget the tribulations of, you know, being in a freaking high-speed gunfight chase, you know, in a Jeep with fucking motorcycles. You know, this should feel really, really familiar to you all. Oh yeah! Uncharted 4, we did that! Where we were in a Jeep fighting fucking motorcycles! Don't worry! This was from scratch, you guys! We didn't do this, you know, Lost Legacy did it first! Nope! Fuck you, Naughty Dog, you lying assholes! Anyway, so we're gonna, you know, just terrorize all these motorcycles. And then, you know, after we're done terrorizing motorcycles, you know, we're gonna hop off this fucking Jeep, you know, in a very unrealistic way. Oh my god, that leap! You kidding me?
Come on, I'll pull you.
And now we're gonna do it for the driver's seat! What?! Oh my god. Anyways, we're gonna get on these trains now. Because, you know, this game is, you know, brand new and not from scratch. We haven't, you know, done a freaking train scene before. Don't worry, you guys. This is the first time, you know, you're gonna encounter a, you know, running along a train car, you know, shootout situation, right? Because, you know, the co-writer Josh here, you know, told us that this game was, you know, from scratch. You know, he didn't, you know, it's all brand new stuff. This is brand new, you guys. Look at this. You know, we're on a train. We're shooting at trucks and motorcycles and we're running and we're jumping. This is all brand new stuff. This is pretty freaking cool, right? Oh my god. Look at this shit. Yep, haven't done this before. Oh, wait a minute. Uncharted 2. Oh, are you kidding me? Are we going to be on a train again? What? But Josh, I thought you just told us that, you know, Lost Legacy was from scratch and you didn't reuse anything. Wait a minute. You're gonna tell me that in Uncharted 2, Nathan, you know, had to run around on a damn train and fight stuff? But Naughty Dog, why? Lost Legacy is supposed to be from scratch. You mean we did this before? Aw. Aw, man, Naughty Dog, why? Why you gonna lie to us? Why you gonna lie to us like this? You know, having these gunfights on these damn trains. Damn it! Here I thought I had new content like you promised. Bullshit! But yeah, this is some crap, man. If you go back to freaking Lost Legacy. Alright, so you're gonna jump around on fucking cars and shit. You know, high speeds, and you're able to, you know, meticulously jump into these moving cars while being shot at, and for somehow one bullet doesn't accidentally, you know, puncture your skull. Oh shit, we're gonna jump to a goddamn truck. Oh my god. Oh my god, we're being dragged. Almost shit. Hold on, Chloe. Don't worry, this is brand new content, you guys. Naughty Dog said, you know, everything's from scratch. Brand new content. You know, getting dragged by trucks is brand new shit, you guys. They said so. You know, we're gonna go and blow shit up. Show them what's up. Mass destruction. Because, you know, Uncharted is all about super unrealistic, you know, fight scenes. And action sequences. Blow it all up, Chloe. You got this, girl. You're a one-woman army. Yeah, get that heavy dude in there. Man, he sure was an idiot being in a freaking train car filled with propane.
We need to bail now.
You know, another super far unrealistic jump. Holy shit, that must have been like 50 feet. Oh yeah, don't forget about, you know, cranes. It's all about swinging around on cranes. Don't forget this shit. This is all brand new. From scratch, remember? Anyway, so then you go back to Uncharted 4, right? And this is where I'm... Oh, goddamn crane! Holy fuck! We're swinging from a fucking crane! So wait, Chloe wasn't the first to do that? Aw, me a naughty dog. Why? You gonna lie to us again? Okay, no worries. No. Oh, what? Now we're gonna get dragged behind a truck? What? But Naughty Dog, you said that freaking, you know, Chloe, you know, did everything from scratch. Aw, man. So here we are getting dragged. Here I thought that was some new, you know, action-packed shit that hadn't been done before. And then here I find out freaking Nathan did it. Dang it, Naughty Dog. How could you break our spirits like this? Yeah, follow that damn truck, you like damn ragdoll. You know, oh my gosh. This is so unrealistic. There's no way he would have survived being dragged like that. He's a dead man. Ugh, such stupid shit, man. Anyways, now we're back in freaking even further back. Going to Uncharted 3, where we're, you know, reusing these freaking, you know, truck scenes. Car chases and all that shit. Because, you know, we love recycling that. Oh, it's a fucking crane! You goddamn kidding me? We did cranes here too? Oh my god, it's all about the cranes. Don't forget these magical fucking concoctions that are cranes. Oh, what's gonna happen here? You're gonna tell me we're after we're in this high speed chase? We're gonna have to, you know, save our buddy? You know, save him? And then we're gonna have to go into a freaking fist fight or something, right? Yep, fist fight time. Oh my god. Don't worry. Don't worry, you guys. This is not gonna happen in The Lost Legacy, okay? This is a cool scene. This was an amazing scene from Uncharted 3. There's no way they're gonna copy that. You know what I mean? There's no way Naughty Dog would do us wrong like that, right? I mean, they're fucking Naughty Dog. They get all the gamer awards for creativity and gameplay and shit, right? They know what's up. They're original. You know, we just like, you know, swinging from cranes in our games, you know? High-paced action fucking car chases. Don't worry. Don't worry, guys. We won't see this again. We will not see this again. I promise you. I promise you. Ah, shit. Never mind. Naughty Dog lied. So we're still, you know, in a high-speed chase. You know, and we're doing a goddamn fist fight. Ah, man. It took, you know, the stuff from Uncharted 3 right here. Now we're copying Uncharted 3 right here. Fist fights and shit. Aw, man. There's even a scene during this fight where, you know, Mr. Angry Man there tosses fucking Nadine over the ledge and you have to, you know, help her out or whatever. So they literally pick the same fucking thing. Anyway, so we're gonna jump off shit, you know. This happened too. I didn't get the clip. But I'm sure you guys will remember a part where, you know, Nathan's hanging from a train and he has to climb up through the train before it falls off of a cliffside. Very familiar. Very familiar. This all happens. It's all about these magical ropes, though, that, you know, you can just launch from your goddamn pocket in Uncharted. Magical ropes are what keeps this game series afloat, ladies and gentlemen. It's all about the ropes.
Oh my god. It's all muscle. That's what they all say.
Oh my god, I forgot the stupid Marco Polo shit! So here we go, the first
hey,
time.
Uncharted
2.
Really?
Come on.
No.
Marco.
Oh, Nathan, you cracked me up with your Marco Polo joke. You're so funny. Ha ha ha. It's a bad joke. Let's hope you never retell it. Aw, shit. Oh no, he's going into a pool for the second time now in Uncharted 3 this time. Oh man, Marco Polo joke again. Oh man. Why, Nathan? Oh! And then Uncharted 4, we're gonna go for another swim. Oh, why? Why we gotta keep doing this to ourselves? The joke's not funny. It's not funny. So we're really gonna just... Oh man, Marco, what? Yeah, exactly, Marco, what? It's all for these goddamn trophies. You know, let's just throw a Marco Polo related trophy in every fucking Uncharted game. Because it's fucking hilarious. Don't worry. It's all from scratch, everybody. Chloe's not gonna fall for that bullshit. That's just all Nathan, right? Aw, man, nope.
Nothing.
More Marco Polo references. Damn it!
Oh my god, you're serious.